What's going on, guys? It's your boy Fox back in the house with a very special video that I've been working on for a little bit now. Today we're going to be talking about the former queen, the former ace of Wellston, Seraphina herself, one of my favorite characters throughout the entire series. Today we're going to be going over her personality, her relationships with some other characters, her powers, and where she might end up by the end of the series. Now, granted, everything I'm about to say is purely my speculation and purely my opinion. If you don't agree with it, that's perfectly fine. We can have a reasonable debate about it in the comments below, or you can go to my Discord where I hang out with some of my other subs and all that. But quick side note before we get started, if you're brand new to this channel, welcome. My name is TheMrFoxX. I do mostly unordinary content, but I do other stuff as well. So if you don't know how this stuff goes, sit down, relax, grab yourself a favorite drink, grab yourself your favorite snack, because I like to talk and I like to ramble. Hopefully this video will not be too long. So let's jump straight into her personality. Now, when we first meet Seraphina, she comes off as very playful and sarcastic when she is around our main character, John, and all that. Now, when she gets around other people, she kind of tends to be like, you know, mind your own business. And honestly, that is Seraphina's personality in a nutshell, to me at least. So backing up to how she was before John ever came into the picture, Seraphina was raised to be a high tier, even though technically she is considered a god tier. But when she was, I guess, like a first year or something, we can probably say she was just a high tier. But Seraphina was raised to be that way. She made perfect grades. She was the strongest in the school. She was the former queen. Well, before she met John, she was the acting queen. She was participating regularly in turf wars, and she was very good. She stated a while back that when she used to do hand-to-hand combat training when she was little, but after her ability manifested itself, her parents focused on training her ability to its utmost. And it, as we saw when she still had her ability, she was really high up on the tier list and everything. But Seraphina's personality was pretty much, if you don't have the strength to back up what you're trying to prove, then just mind your own business. And that's really flawed, thinking and everything. I don't blame her, considering how the world of Unordinary is structured with the hierarchy and all of that. So I'm pretty sure most people feel that way, like she did. But it was more so for her, because Seraphina did not want to be bothered with other people, because she always had these expectations that were placed on her. She, like I said, she was a top student in pretty much everything. Seraphina was pretty much talented in anything that she did. And this made this kind of made everyone put her on this pedestal, to where it wasn't even like a cool thing, like, oh yeah, you make good grades. It got to the point where it was just expected, like, you better make A's. Obviously her mother wanted her to do nothing but make A's, but it also got to the same point with her peers and everything, because whenever she would get an A on a test and the rest of the class didn't do so well, the teacher would point it out and they would be like, well, of course Seraphina made an A, and you know, she's on a different level than us. And this infuriated her, because she's like, no, I just actually studied the material. She's like, I didn't wake up and just, I was good like this. I study, I train, I do all the stuff that I have to do. And this really bothered her, because even though that she was doing technically everything that she was supposed to do, that you would expect of the perfect model student, she felt like everybody else got to do what they want, and that and got to do what I want. By what I mean by that is that she would see her peers, you know, just goofing off, you know, texting in class or just going out and hanging out with one another and doing teenager things, while she was probably stuck in her house studying. And then maybe probably after studying, she had to do combat training with her ability to make sure that she stays in tip-top shape with it. Not on top of the other stuff she had to do at school. Because we don't really know what the job of king, queen, and jack really entails. We just know that they kind of keep the order, and they're not just figureheads. Like, they do represent the power of the school for the most part. But we don't know, like, if they're like the student council or whatever. But Seraphina's personality greatly changed when John actually stepped into the picture. He really kind of flipped her world upside down, but she still kind of held on to some of those hierarchical views on life and everything. And this kind of gets proven to me when, after John's fight with Gavin, they skip the hospital. Well, they leave the infirmary and go out to get some drinks and everything. John was talking about what's wrong with just, you know, trying to talk things out. And that's when Seraphina stated, she's like, what's the point of talking to someone that's weaker than you? And John's like, oh, it's okay. It's okay that you can just overpower them. And Seraphina's like, pretty much like, yeah. She's like, if you don't have the strength to back up your point, then mind your own business. And John is like, look, that's not cool. And then Seraphina gets mad about this, and he has to restate. He's like, look, I'm not talking about you. I'm just talking about high tiers in general. Which, I mean, technically she is included in that, but, you know, I'm just saying. So Seraphina definitely still had that hierarchy mentality when she still had her ability. And I want to stress that a lot right now is that everything, her personality up till now that I've been talking about, is when she still had her ability. Now, when Seraphina actually lost her ability, she is now learning how the other side of the coin is dealing with things, how the mid tiers and the low tiers and the cripples have to live, because now she herself is a cripple. And that really got hammered home to her when she was abducted by Wen K and her group of thugs, and they pretty much tortured Seraphina all for the sake of getting revenge on the high tiers, which, and to me, doesn't really make sense, because that's just one person. It's like, and even then, you didn't even beat this person when they were at their best. You beat them when they're literally at their lowest, and they have the hardest time to even defend themselves. But this getting a little bit off topic and everything. So while Seraphina is, you know, being tortured and all that, she's trying to remain strong, because as we know, she does admire John. She admires John greatly. Before she found out that he actually had an ability and all that, she's like, I admire the fact that he's able to just be himself, even though that he is a cripple and everyone is always trying to pick a fight with him for no real reason. And she's like, I respect that so much, and I'm going to try and mimic that. And she does. So before she got kidnapped, we know she had that fight with Krolik, and she saved Evie. That right there demonstrated to me that John really is rubbing off on her a great, great deal. More so than she probably thinks, because she kind of felt like, I'll just help out, and it'll just be the end of it. I don't think she expressly stated that, but I mean, her face expressions and all that, that's what I got from. She's like, look, I'll help you out, just because this kind of distracting me and everything. But still, she does care about other people now, and I'm really curious to see where her personality and all that is gonna go now that she knows that John is now that she knows John is Joker and everything. Because I think she's gonna have to learn how to forgive in these upcoming arcs, and just this upcoming season. But we'll talk about that when I get to how things will end up and everything. So Yeah, but personality-wise, Seraphina, up until she lost her abilities, she was pretty much like, if you ain't got the strength to back up your words, mind your business. Now, in the current storyline, I feel like she's like, if I can help, I will. But she's still kind of scared of just jumping into the battlefield like she used to, because, you know, now she just can't one hit KO someone and they're done. And it's like she really has to think and calculate her moves, like John did when he was pretending to be a cripple and everything. But yeah, so let's jump straight into her powers. So jumping into her powers and abilities, we have not yet received any official confirmation on what Seraphina's power used to be before she lost it. But for the most part, I feel like me, a lot of others in the community as a whole have just agreed that her ability is time manipulation, because we know what her mother's is. Her mother's ability is time manipulation. I think she was a 7.8. And we also know that abilities can be hereditary, because Remy's ability is lightning and so is her brother, Ray, or Ecstatic was his hero name, RIP to him. So for the sake of this video, we are going to say that her ability is time manipulation. Now, most of the time when time powers come into play in like anime or whatever, I usually don't like it, because it's really hard to make time manipulation powers like not broken. So I'm going to say that we all know that Seraphina can stop time and she can rewind time. I'm going to say she can only stop and rewind time for no more than 5 seconds, which still in its own right is really broken, because that is a lot of time when you're in a fight. If you've ever been in an actual fight before, you know what I'm talking about. So, but how strong is Seraphina? And to answer that question, when Seraphina gets dragged into a turf war with Arlo and Blyke, when Arlo tells her that Remy has some personal business to handle and all that, we meet up with Wellston's, I guess, rival or whatever, Ogwin High School and everything. Ogwin's king is named Brovin, and their new queen was Rain. Now, their Jack, I don't really remember his name, but that's really not that important. But when Arlo and Seraphina and Blyke show up on the beach with Ogwin and everything, Arlo mentions that we have Seraphina with us. And at first, Brovin was like, the name sounds familiar, and then it clicks. So apparently, at one point in time, when Seraphina was still the acting queen and still participating regularly, she single-handedly took down the entire roster of Ogwin all by herself. Now, if you don't know about this, turf wars can be fought, as far as my knowledge knows from looking on the wiki and everything, turf wars can be fought 3-on-3 or 1-on-1, and that is what Seraphina and Arlo and Blyke did when they showed up. They did the 1-on-1. But they can't be fought 3-on-3. And when the last time they went 3-on-3, Seraphina on her own wiped out the entire squad. That should let you know how strong she is. But also, during the fight, when Rain is defeated by Arlo, Arlo decides to keep going because he says he's disappointed in her, in their new queen's ability and all that. Now, we all know what Arlo's ability is. It is barrier. And if you hit that barrier, whether you break it or not, you're going to get reflective damage and all that. So while Arlo is choking Rain out, Seraphina tells him to stop. He completely ignores her. She runs up on Arlo and she breaks the barrier. Now also, if you are able to break Arlo's barrier, he does take damage from it, and he takes severe damage because he was coughing up blood when she broke it. Now she also got reflective damage from that, but she was able to rewind time around her arm. Now that lets me know that she's not only able to just rewind time around her whole body, she's also to pinpoint and just do specific spots, such as just her arm, or maybe had it been like she did a kick, she could have just rewound time around the wound around her leg. Which, like I said, I'm hoping I don't know how long she can do it, but no more than a few seconds, because anything past that is really, really broken. And honestly, that's probably why Uru-chan, besides the fact that Seraphina has a greater plot point in the story, that's probably why she went ahead and took away her ability, because she probably realized that this ability is really, really broken. Because in all the fight scenes that we got with Seraphina throughout the story, and we don't have too many, she one-shots every opponent she comes across. She one-shotted Arlo. I'm pretty sure had they gone in an all-out brawl 100%, he could take more hits, but for the most part, she one-shotted his barrier, it broke, he started bleeding. Now, the chapter where John and Seraphina go to the mall and John realizes that someone is following them, after John throws a shirt on the invisible person, Seraphina stops time and goes and kicks him. Once again, and it wasn't just like a simple light kick where she kicked him and he dropped. She kicked him and he went several meters away. So not only is her ability OP, she can hit really, really hard. And I don't know if it's because she hits you in time and stop that the impact is a little bit greater, or she's just really that strong on her own. And then also another scene we got where she proved her ability is when John comes in contact with Gavin again and all that, but Seraphina is there this time and they get into it and she drops him in like maybe half a second flat. And at that point in time, we didn't know what her ability might be, because it was like literally a panel of her standing there, Gavin rushing, and then she ends up behind him and she just kind of elbows him in the back of the neck and he's out for the count. So yeah, Seraphina is definitely a powerhouse. She is a monster. Even though she stopped doing hand-to-hand combat training after her ability manifested itself in grade school, the ranking of 8.0 is very deserving of her, because not only was her ability mastery really good, but she hits like a truck. And, you know, like I said, every opponent that we've seen her go up against in the story so far one-shot it. And even back then, when she first met John, there was a scene where John got the piece of the famous chocolate cake that's in the school or whatever. And side note, that chocolate cake must be just delicious, because everybody ends up fighting over a piece of that cake. And to be honest, I don't even like sweets like that, let alone cake, especially chocolate cake like that. That didn't look good. But anywho, jumping back into it, so that day John managed to get a piece of cake. Now also, let me remind you, this is also when John and Seraphina just met. Seraphina rolls up on John and she's like, give me that cake. She's pretty much pulling rank on him. John, being the person that he is, no. And they go back and forth a little bit. Ultimately, John ends up throwing the cake on the ground, which by nature is blasphemous. Even though I don't like sweets, you don't waste food like that, John. You just don't do it. But after that, Seraphina uses her ability and she knocks him out. She hits him into the wall and the wall cracks around him. But even after that, she keeps going in on John. So case in point, Seraphina's abilities and her powers and her physical capabilities, they are nothing to play with. Obviously, she's better at hand-to-hand combat now. She's not on the same level as John, but she can handle her own, because she took out Krolik, even though he's just a mid-tier, but still. She was handling her business very, very well. So yeah, when Seraphina had her ability, she was very deserving of the title Ace that she bestowed upon herself. So yeah, so I mean, that's really it about her powers. I wish I could go more. I could do a speculation video about, you know, what all, like every facet of her ability and what she could and could not do, but I'll probably save that for another video, another day. So we're going to jump into her relationships with other characters. I'm going to jump into the ones that matter the least, and then I'll save the ones that are more important for like the last bit of this. So her relationship with Blike and Aizen, I think the only connection she has with Blike is the fact that she chose him for the rank of Jack because she didn't trust Cecile. Other than that, I really don't think she has any form of contact with Aizen or Blake unless they happen to be with Remy and she sees her down the hallway. Now, her relationship with Elaine, I think she just views Elaine as an annoying roommate, because every time Elaine talks to her, it just seems she's like, what? She looks like, why are you talking to me? Like, chill out and everything. Now, her relationship with Arlo. Now, from what we know, Seraphina and Arlo do not like each other at all. Now, that is really going to be up for debate now that she knows the truth about John being Joker and everything. And Arlo came straight out and told her. So, I'm very interested to see how their relationship is going to develop, if it does at all, from, you know, when the new season kicks off and everything. So I'm really, really curious. But for the most part, Seraphina and Arlo never got along. I really wish they would expand upon that more. If they have, let me know so I can go. And if you know the chapter, if they've done that, then let me know so I can go check it out. But for the most part, they don't get along. I think they're going to become better friends. Take that back. I think they will be friends by when the new season kicks off. Maybe not like right at the beginning, but at some point down the line, maybe like the quarter mark or something like that. Because he did come straight out and tell her. But I mean, he also kept a lot of things from her. And he was kind of the catalyst for this. But now, jumping into the relationship with her mother, well, not even just her mother, with her family in general. Her relationship with her sister seems fine. We have not seen them in the same frame. We have not seen them interact with each other yet. I know it's coming in this upcoming season, because when Layla had that dinner with Darren, told her about Seraphina, she didn't come out and say that's her sister, but she had a very concerned look on her face. I wouldn't doubt it if she goes down to the school and just visits her or whatever. Now, her relationship with her father, we don't know. We haven't seen him. We don't know his name. We ain't seen a picture. I don't know. I'm not going any farther than that. Now, her relationship with her mother, that relationship is strained. I feel like it started when her mother called her sister a failure. Now, I don't know if like her mother and father disowned her older sister, or just like, you know, don't come back to the house or anything like that. We don't know. But considering how her mother acts towards her, I wouldn't put it past her, to be perfectly honest. So I feel like maybe before she kicked her sister out, if she did, her relationship with her mother was probably like average. She like came home like, hey mom, how you doing, and all that. Maybe not, but as of right now, in the current storyline, that relationship is very strained, especially since Seraphina kind of left without her permission. And not only did she just leave without her permission, she left and she made her pay for her flight, or flight, bus ticket, whatever she took to get back to school, first class and everything. So yeah, their relationship is gonna, well, I'm pretty sure we'll see more of them. Actually, to be perfectly honest, now that I'm talking about it, I would really love to see like a dinner between like all of Seraphina's family. We don't know their last name, we don't know her last name or anything, but yeah, I think that'd be awesome, because that'd just be some high tension turkey on that table and everything. But yeah, so that, I mean, that's kind of it with her family. I feel like she's going to be like confused when she sees her sister. Not like confused like, what are you doing here, but she's going to be confused on like, what should I tell her, that I don't have an ability? Is she still gonna, you know, love me and all that? But you know, we'll see. I'm waiting for when Seraphina and her sister finally get to interact with each other in the story and everything. Now, the most prominent relationship she has in the entire story is, as we know, her relationship with John. Now, most of us want to see them get together. I think they'd be a cute couple, but you know, I'm still Team Cecile and Team John, even though it's never going to happen. And if you want to talk to me about it, fight me. Just fight me. But no, on a serious note, I feel like her relationship with John, excluding the whole thing where she just found out that he's been lying to her from the beginning and he's Joker and all that, but excluding that part, she has expressly stated that she admires John very, very highly. And the reason behind that is because, like I said, before she found out that he was lying to her, she was inspired and in awe of the fact that John was able to pretty much do what he want, despite the fact of him being a cripple. Because John never let that get him down. He never let that stop him from going in and helping someone that was really in need. John did not hesitate to help out that one boy that was getting beaten up by Gavin. And he fought Gavin. And as we know, one of the funniest scenes still to me to this day is he threw Gavin straight out of a window. And even though, yes, John has aura manipulation at a 10.0 on the power scale, he did not use it. And she admired this greatly. She's like, I want to be like that. I want to be able to do what I want to do no matter what. And I want to be able to be me. I don't care about what people think about me. I don't want to care about any of that. I just want to hang out, have fun, and just live my life the way I want to. That is the part that she admired the most about John. And even if you leave all that out, that is her best friend. Because John showed her that all these expectations, your reputation, none of that matters in the grand scheme of things. The only thing that matters is that you are able to live with yourself. And honestly, that is a great lesson to teach to anyone. You need to be able to live with yourself and the decisions that you make in life, whether it's a good decision or a bad decision. You need to be able to go home at night, look yourself in the mirror, and be like, even though this might not have turned out the way that I wanted to, I'm still happy that I did it. And you should never let anyone's opinions, whether it be family, whether it be your significant other, dictate on how you act and what you want to do. Now, granted, if you're trying to commit some really heinous and evil things, then you need to stop and think about what people are saying to you. But if you just want to have fun and live your life, go ahead and have fun. Still take care of business, because yes, even though Seraphina and John skipped class, John's grades questionable, but Seraphina was still maintaining A's. But if she got a B here and there, it didn't bother her as much, because like I said, in the part where I was talking about her personality, she used to stress out about not getting straight A's and all that, because especially when her and John got partnered up for that class project and they got a B on the first part or the second part, I can't remember, she flipped out and she threatened to beat John so much that he will be in the hospital every single day to make sure that they get an A on this project, because she was used to doing it by herself. Because who doesn't want a free A? Trust me. In high school, if you did the project and you're like, we'll get an A, I'm like, handle it, homie. Go do your thing. I am not going to stop you. Trust me. But yeah, that is probably the best. John is kind of the best slash almost the worst thing that has happened to her. Best because he taught her how to live her life and not let anyone's expectations hold her down. But also the worst because, well, no, take that back, I lied. The whole Amber thing, it would have happened either way, because even though John was the one that told Seraphina to, you know, take that test and all that, I feel like it would have happened eventually. I mean, because they were searching for high tiers and all that and everything. So, yeah, but, you know, so we're going to leave that part out. So John was the best thing that happened to her personality-wise. And even now that she is a cripple, John still has a great influence on her, because now as a cripple, she's actually helping other people out. When she still had her ability, the only people she would really help out was John. And she might have helped out Remy, but let's be honest, Remy didn't really need help. Well, except in that fight with Vulcan, she almost got killed, but you know. But yeah, for the most part, like I said, Seraphina's whole mentality back in the day was, if you don't have the strength to back it up, be quiet, mind your business, hopefully you can skate on by. Now that she's a cripple, she saw Evie in need of help. She went and helped her. And now Evie and her are getting really close. And I really, really enjoy Evie and Seraphina's friendship right now. And actually her friendship with Evie's friends, I feel like it's really helpful for Seraphina's personality and all that. But yeah. So yeah, John, I'm really scared for their relationship. I know I have an idea how things are going to go for when the season kicks back up and everything. But their relationship for the most part right now is broken. I've said it many times, when the season kicks up, I'm not gonna be surprised if Seraphina's whole goal is to avoid John until she's able to figure some things out. And hopefully Evie will and her friends will help her navigate through her feelings, and John and Seraphina will have a sit down and talk. It's going to have to happen for plot reasons, but still, I'm ready for that. So yeah, that is her relationships with most of the characters in Unordinary and all that. Well, the ones that I feel that were, I guess, the most important and all that. I don't really like her relationship with like the headmaster. I'm saying Vaughn and Darren and the staff. I mean, I guess she respects them because they're authority figures, but who really cares? So, moving on, we're going to be jumping into what I think is going to happen to her in the future of Unordinary and how she'll turn out by the end of Unordinary and everything. So, where is Seraphina going to end up by the end of Unordinary? Honestly, there are a few things that could happen. Some feel that she might end up dead, which honestly, if it's done correctly, I am okay with. And some feel that she might get her powers back also. If done correctly, I am okay with that. But for me, it's more about the journey. So jumping into how I'm feeling about how season 2 is going to be, like I've said a few times before, I feel like when the season kicks off, Seraphina and John are going to be on a no speaking basis. I feel like this is really going to push John over the edge, because for the most part, this was kind of for Seraphina, of him taking down the royals and all that. It was a little bit of revenge too, but I feel like a decent chunk of it was to protect Seraphina and to make sure that no one messes with her anymore or anything like that, because you know she got beaten up, her and John got beaten up by Zeke, then she got kidnapped and by Wen K and her friends, and even before that she was abducted by Ember for a little bit. She got injected with that by that syringe, and whatever was in that syringe was what took her powers back, and they have not come back since then. If they do come back, like I said, I'm fine with it. It's just I hope the execution for it is done well. That'd be my biggest gripe. If it's just really shoehorned in or anything like that, I'm gonna have like a problem. I'll get over it, but still, it's gonna just kind of taint the story a little bit for me and everything. But by the end of the series, I really just want Seraphina and John to be back on good terms, and actually maybe even dating. Like, they don't have to date. I mean, because that's like the fun of shipping wars and all that. It drives sales, it drives the community and all that. So I get the point of shipping wars and all that, and why creators kind of love it or whatever. But I wouldn't mind if Seraphina and John were like, let's go away, not run off and elope or anything like that, but just like, we're dating. Let's the two of us. Seraphina's family is rich, so they got, well, she has money. John does not. We don't know if John has money. I mean, his dad, even though the book Unordinary got banned, I'm pretty sure it brought in a, you know, pretty penny and all that. I mean, I don't know. We don't know. So who knows? But you know, they could just be like, look, we're dating now. Everything is just crazy. It's hectic. Let's go away. Do the generic beach scene that a lot of manga and anime and all that do and everything. So I really kind of hope that John and Seraphina just reconcile everything, because I want Seraphina to really understand why John did what he did. Now, like I said before, I do not completely agree with John and his methods, and he's not 100% justified in the actions that he has taken against the royals and everything, but I can also empathize with him on why he did what he did, because honestly, what he did is a little bit of normal human nature to kind of want to get revenge and lash out like that. Should you do it? No. You should definitely find a better outlet for it. But do I understand why you do it? Yeah. I mean, on top of that, like, and sometimes I got to remind people, you do realize these are like teenagers, right? These are not grown, like, adults who have experienced life a little bit or anything like that. These are teenagers. Like, you don't know anything in high school, trust me. If you think you do, you don't. Life, when you get out there in the real world, life will smack you upside the head 8 ways a Sunday, more times than you will be able to keep up with. But so yeah, I just want Seraphina, and I'm kind of hoping for the happy ending. Even though if you watch some of the videos that I've done and the collaborations that I've done with other unordinary YouTubers like Digi, Ty, Steph, and all that, you'll sometimes you get the vibe that I just want a dark ending. And honestly, I don't really care. It's not that I don't care about the ending. I just want an ending that is befitting of Unordinary. And what I mean by that is I want the ending to make sense in the context of Unordinary, its story, and the universe that Uru-sensei has set up for us. If I get anything that's less than that, I get upset. So is whether the story makes it to where someone has to die, I'm okay with, or the story manages to execute where they can all live happily ever after, I'm okay with that. And personally, I don't want to see Seraphina suffer any more than she has to. Like, because the scene after she was rescued from Winke and her goon squad and all that, when she broke down to John and she told him that, she's like, I tried my best, but it wasn't enough. That, and John just like hugged her and he was like, it'll be okay. I almost lost it. You can go back and watch that reaction I did. I can't remember what chapter it is. I'll find it and I'll put up a card or whatever for it. But yeah, that really tugged on your boy's heartstrings and all that. So yeah, as far as what I'm saying is, I wouldn't mind if Seraphina and John get together and they just go on a vacation. They just go away for a little bit. Or it'd be bittersweet, but I'd be cool with they come to an understanding of each other, but Seraphina decides, you still lied to me, so we're cool, but we can't be friends, and they go their separate ways. Now, like I said, it'd be very bittersweet. Very, very bittersweet. I'd be highly, highly upset. But if it's done correctly, I will accept it and I will move on with my life. And hopefully you will be able to as well. So yeah, man. But this video right here has been a little bit in the making. I have been putting it off and been putting it off because I really wanted to take my time with this video. And even after recording all of this audio footage and everything, it's probably still going to take me a little bit of time to actually get this out to you. So if you stuck around to the end, I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And I will be doing more videos like this. Hopefully I'll be able to do a video with each one of our main cast members. I want to do one for Aizen Blake. I've already done one for Remy. I'll definitely I'm going to do one about Arlo. Because Arlo, to me, is a very interesting character. But, like I said, y'all, I ramble and all that. But, guys, tell me what you think about Seraphina. Tell me, what do you want to see her character go? Do you want her to get her powers back? Do you not? Do you not even care? Do you want her to die at some point during the series or towards the end? Or do you want her and John to, like I said, just run off and chill out? Or do you just want her just to, you know, get her powers back and see her smash some ember heads in or anything like that? But like I've said before, if you're new to this channel, my name is TheMrFoxX. I thank you for sticking around to the end of this video and everything. Guys, I hope you really have a wonderful day or night or evening or whenever you are watching this video. And make sure you like, comment, subscribe, really hit that like button because it really helps your boy out. And with all that being said, I hope you have a good day. And it's your boy Fox out.